Meanwhile, I'll see what else I can learn while we're here. Maybe I'll send a few Einherjar back to Valhalla for good measure.
Well, you have fun now.
Hey, you made it! About time. I got everything all set here. Now we just gotta push on up to the fort.
Folky!
You sure did go to pains coming here, busting old Tyr loose. What a prize he turned out to be, huh? Lucid enough when it's time to steal my kitchen, though. Better take out that nest, or it'll be eyeball city down here! These mutts? No wonder they shut the door.
Get used to that trick.
Locals up ahead. Act civilized, and hopefully nobody springs an alarm. No, quit your nattering, you snake-sucking mommy milksops with your protective gear. Ain't you never seen a legend in the flesh before? Well, that ain't no good. You see what's wrong here, don't you? Those creepy flying eyeballs made a nest up on the cables. We gotta figure a way up there and clear them all. Okay, looks like that wheel up there opened up. Not that we can reach it or anything. No grappling up that way. Why don't you look around and see if there's a way to lift this lift?
Brother, did you notice the dwarves of the camp were twice as alarmed to see Brok than they were to see you?
They did seem surprised.
All right. Now I can turn this crank and cap that geyser there. You just give me the signal when you're ready.
Now.
On it! Well, that got the gate open, but you kind of need to be up here.
Turn it.
Copy that.
Turn it again.
Aye, aye. He is dead. We gotta have a full stop at once, Steve.
Once more.
Aye, aye. Hey, I got the crank covered. You do the other stuff. Look around. Find it.
Again.
Hey, I got the crank covered. You do the other stuff.
We need a new vantage point, brother.
Hey, I got the crank covered. You do the other stuff.
Can we get up any higher from here? Ah, promising.
Up here to use it, you dig? seen it. Look out! Up above you! Take that nest out so the thing can move. That's why we're up here, remember? Big Boomer coming up! Finally! Now we can ride on up to the forge. Come on! The lady's waiting. Hey, got another riddle for you. What gets bigger the more you take away from it?
Well, let's see. Something abstract, I expect. Appetite? No, that doesn't work.
Stump the stump.
Oh, isn't that clever? Bam.
Some for the lady.
Grab some what? The wind?
No, you idiot. The sound of the wind.
How?
Watch and learn. See? Dwarven magic's all about the intangibles. The relationship between the stuff what you can touch and what you can't. It's about understanding.
Understanding what?
The nature of a thing's more important than the form of a thing. Hang on! I smell trouble.
Nasty! Hey, you all right, brother? So this lady, then.
The lady of the forge. Ain't a more magical creature in this realm. Why, I've been waiting for my chance to meet her since I was knee-high to a Noken. But Sindri'd never have it. Said I was too uncouth. But today's finally the day. Whoa, I got goosebumps on my bunions.
Why, bro? I've never seen you so... reverent. Are you nervous?
What? Shut up. No, fuck you. Go on, Pasty. Turn the crank. Let's do this.
It does not work.
Huh? What is it this time? Out of the way. Let me... Do I gotta fix everything in this dang city my own self? I'm gonna need a couple of things. Follow me. Yeesh, this place ain't in some disrepair. It's disrespectful, I tell you. I need that axe of ours to go kiss that material out yonder. The spiky, silvery stuff. You'll figure it out.
This lady, what does she do?
Well... we'll both see soon enough, won't we? I know this, though. If we're real lucky, she'll give us her blessing. Doesn't give them to every piece, but the ones she does, there's something to behold.
The axe?
Well, that particular process was a whole nother cluster, huh? Maybe sometime I'll spin you that tale. Ha! Faye's the only one who ever got my highbrow sense of humor. Damn fine woman she was. Apart from her taste in men, of course. Now I need a chunk of that bronze material over by all that busted up wood. Back in those days, I'd get so caught up in trying to be the best that I'd work till I plumb dropped. Time goes by and there's less to prove. You learn to keep your own pace. Save your extra effort for when it's personal. Like when you finally get to show the lady who you are. Wow, Goaty, you sure did give up on that riddle in a hurry.
I give up nothing. Gets bigger the more you take away, is it?
That's right.
Sorted. It's desire.
Nope.
What do you mean, nope? Desire only grows when you take away the thing you desire. All right, it's not perfect, but let's hear your answer.
Oh, you won't get it out of me that easy. All right, let's get back to business. One more crank to turn and it's on to the forge.
I see no forge.
You don't see the form of a forge, but we're going to the nature of one.
I was almost following him for a moment there.
We're good! Crank it!
Where's the forge?
She needs the final ingredient. The blood of a god. Give her your hand. Thank you. coffee drinker almost forgot. Ma'am, it would be an honor if you might bless it for us. Are you, Hello? Hello? The fuck was that? She acts like I weren't even here.
Mermaids don't speak to our corporeal bodies. They speak to a part of our soul. A part specifically you might be missing.
Fuck. Fuck! Damn it, Sindri, you lion cat scrubber! I knew it. I died. I fucking died! The fuck you want?
It needs a blessing.
Yeah, well, the one to give us the blessing just fucked off into the tomb.
It needs the blessing of a great blacksmith.
What? No, no, I can't bless shit. I don't have all my soul bits. The blessing wouldn't mean squat.
It is the nature of a thing that matters. Not its form.
All right. May this weapon strike true. May it be wielded with wisdom. May it be put down when its job is done.
Let us return home.
You take our new gal home without giving her a twirl. Stop! Look! We got a volunteer! She can help us get out of here, too. Up there, see that weak spot? Jam one in right there. That's it! guess we're doing this one boy style. Listen, I appreciate what you said back there. It's good to have friends when you find out your brother's a rack-scabbing liar.
No doubt he only wished to protect you.
Weren't his fault, mate. The guy dies, he's got the right to know about.
Take heart, Brok. We all die sometime. Many of us more than once.
No, never mind all that. We gotta finish putting the spirit through our paces. Come on! Might have to get creative up ahead. Oh, lick my face! There's eyeball nests all over! Get your throwing arm in gear!
Oh. Bed on the left!
The nest! Get the dang nest!
Above you, brother!
Better take out that net, or it'll be Eyeball City out here.
Nightmare, left flank.
Stop bunkering around and smash that thing before more things come out.
Behind you, look out!
Don't you see where they're coming from? Hit it already! Any more guesses, Belt Boy?
Oh, all right. Gets bigger the more you take away. Is it time? Because the more removed from events you become, the larger their scope in your memory. No, that's bollocks now that I say it. Never mind.
Today's all right. Them eyeballs are taking over the realm. We better beat them out. Show me what you got!
Poison left side!
Watch your right! I'm right here, you bastard! Let go already!
Nice, watch out!
Well, that was creepy. must be talking to yourself. Figuring stuff out faster than I can teach. See? Dirty enough to climb on, swing on, whatever's you need.
For that.
It's all about the proper angle. I'm telling you, you're too far to the side.
One of these holds children. Put it in the trap.
Me to scare you or anything.
You did not.
Right. You can bring that back to Ratatosh Group whenever you're ready.
Got one last favor to ask of the both of you, and we can call a square. What happened down there in the forge with the lady? That's my story to tell, all right?
Agreed.
Oh, very well.
These ugly bugs. Maybe those drum will take him down. Got something for you?
Look out!
enough heart pumping for me today. You pick up the loot. I'll set up shop over yonder.
Thank you, Brok. It is a good spear.
Damn straight it is. Reckon I see how you'll be getting down from up here. Best I find my own way back. Been too auspicious a day to end it orking and borking.
Oh, is that the way down?
And I'll get those gates working for you.
I only hope Sindri's in one piece by the time Brok's done with him. The ice beneath those two is thin enough under the best of circumstances. Everyone.
Now a good time. I just want to talk. Dad to dad. Speaking of which, imagine my surprise when Atreus came knocking at my door. He's doing well, by the way, and will continue to do so just as long as I return to Asgard. Sometime soon. Besides, our friend here has a whole lot to live for.
Arguable.
Run along now, but behave yourself. New spear. Never much cared for Brok. Can't deny the dwarf's talent.
You came to speak. Speak.
You don't really want war, do you, Kratos? All that blood on your hands, on your son's hands. I want peace as much as you do. Perhaps we can find it together.
He's lying.
I know.
That boy of ours is everything I expected. So clever. Kind. You sure he's yours? A kid. You really ought to be very proud. He is the key to peace in our age, to break free from all this fate and prophecy.
My son is not your key.
Oh, God, do they not have metaphor in your homeland? Or rather, did they? I'm sorry, that's not fair. I know you're not the god you once were. And now is your chance to prove it.
Return my son, or you may meet the god I once was.
And what kind of god is that, Kratos? What do you even know of godhood? In your lifetimes, has anyone ever worshipped you? Ever prayed to you? Can you even imagine that kind of love? No! You don't care about mortals. You don't care about anything beyond yourself. Beyond the monster who kills without cause. You fear what you can never even hope to understand. Is it any wonder that your boy is in no rush to come back to you?
Don't listen to him, brother. He's just trying to get in your head.
Superior bastard. Where the fuck's going up here? At least you rattled him as much as he rattled you.
Good timing. Let's see what Brok made you.